Nitin Patel. He's the executive director of the company. He's joining us right now to take us through how the quarter gone by has been. Nitin, thanks very much for taking out the time. So obviously you've seen a little bit of a contraction with regards to your EBITDA. Net profits have been down about 37%. Revenues have slumped a little bit. Talk us through whether or not things will change materially here on, and whether this was something that you've seen as a base.
See, actually, if you see in quarter one itself, obviously the revenue has gone down by around 8.5% purely. But the EBITDA margin seems to be well within the range. In fact, it has margin percentage has gone up actually. But because of the tax effect, as compared to the previous year, last year in the same quarter, we were getting the ADIA exemption, and as of now, we are coming under the full tax regime. So that is the reason why the PAT is seems to be a little bit the percentage gap. Obviously, it is coming down by almost around 36-37%. So that is one point. But in fact, if you see the current order in the hand of the company and the way we are expecting the further land acquisition by the authority NHAI to get it through, so we are expecting from Q3 and Q4, we will see the decent uptick actually. And with this, we will be able to recoup the gap what was there in the Q1. And we are expecting the whole of the year, we should be there almost around 3,600 crores of the top line. Provided the balance, the land, what the NHA is supposed to give, it will give, so we will be able to recoup it for the Q3 and Q4.
Could you give us a sense of how you expect execution to pick up come the next few quarters, and also the fact that, your order book position this year is about 10,800 odd crores, which has not seen any material improvement in terms of a pickup in orders?
If you see the order book, obviously it is 3x of the FY19 revenue, so that we see that it is reasonably well. But obviously the new bidding, because of the post-election, not new bids has been started. But as of now, there are the 43 bids under the EPC mode, almost closer to 30,000 crores are there for bidding as per the NHAI website. And also almost around 32 projects costing around 31,000 crore under the hybrid annuity mode. So we are of the view that the bidding process will start basically from now onwards till the end of the year. But in terms of the execution, basically Q3 and Q4, normally post the monsoon, the execution starts picking up. So we are of the view that there will be a decent basically growth to start coming, seeing in the Q3 and Q4 onwards.
Okay. Nitin, what's the update on board considering the merger of both the companies, Sadbhav Engineering as well as Infra?
The board has in principle agreed for the same and appointed the valuer and the advisor. So obviously once the report and everything will come, and then after the board will take a further appropriate step. So as and when the things will further materialize, we will definitely come with the complete clarity and what are the basically thought process and what is the further thinking in terms of the merger.
Sure, but for the benefit of your shareholders, since it's a big step, what sort of synergies do you see with this sort of merger to come by in case it takes place?
See, generally, if you see particularly because Sadbhav Infra 70% ownership is already there with Sadbhav Engineering. So under any circumstances, basically, if you see the business model itself, actually, it is an interdependency of both the businesses there. Number one, now with the asset monetization, which is one of the key trigger, now we have come out, first monetization has been done, and we are in the process of complete the closing of the transaction. And going forward, in the light, when we have already entered the ROFO agreement for all of the present as well as the future assets with the same trust actually. So definitely the company's business model is going to change right from the asset heavy to asset light. So that is what the basically the one of the biggest key point. And then after definitely once the things will come up, then we will be able to figure out the what are the other basically the advantages and the rationale. So this is a clear business synergy what the basically the board and the management is thinking to look into.
Just a last question, Nitin. I'm just looking at one of the brokerage report, which states that 22% of the order backlog is pending because of financial closure and appointed dates. What's the timeline that you can give us in terms of delays that we've seen in terms of appointed date? Will it come in the current quarter or the next quarter?
see, out of the four projects, there are the four projects where financial closure we have completed and the appointed date has not yet taken because of the 80% of the land which is required minimum is not made available by the authority. So out of the same one, we are expecting that the in a particular current quarter, we'll be able to take up, that is the Keem to Ankleshwar. And the second one, Gadag to Honali, that is also one of the ADB-funded project of government of Karnataka. So that we are expecting that it should start basically in the Q3 itself. And the rest other two projects, we are as of now, we are considering in the Q4 because the land acquisition process may take some more time. So as a factor of safety, we are considering. So once it will happen, then definitely we will have a very decent, basically, executable orders for the even next year also. So this will give a clear path so far as the further quarters are concerned.